this lecture, we will see an overview of the main concepts related to the performance measurement of production and logistics systems. The main objectives of performance measurement are the following ones: quantifying in an objective way the results of company processes and activities, promptly identifying anomalies in order to correct them, monitoring the evolution of performances during time while comparing them to the customer's needs and to the objectives of the company, providing incentives or penalties through the principles of management by objectives. There are different elements to be defined in order to create a performance measurement system. Each element answers a question, a set of indicators, which answers to the question what, the measure of the indicators, how, the frequency of the measurement, when, the targets with which the results of the measurement are compared, which target, the functions in charge of the measurement, who. In order to better understand these concepts, let's see an example refer to their application in the e-grocery context. Indicators to measure performances of the logistics system could be the punctuality, the delivery completeness, and the order cycle time. If we consider the punctuality, two examples of measures could be the percentage of orders on time or the average delay per order. The frequency of the measurement could be, for example, one per week or one per month. This choice depends on the trade-off between the amount of information and the costs. The target could be set, for example, to 99% of orders on time on the total delivered orders. In the case of punctuality, the person in charge could be the driver. If we instead consider accuracy, it could be the picker. In order to work properly, a performance measurement system should respect some requirements. Completeness. It has to consider all the factors that significantly impact performances. Precision. It has to be able to detect even small variations of performances, representing them through variations in the value of the indicator. Clarity. It has to provide results which are easily understandable by users. Promptness. It has to provide the results quickly, in order to be able to promptly apply eventual corrective actions. Responsibility focus. It has to consider performances whose responsibility is clearly associated to specific people or functions. Limited costs. Costs to collect data and analyze the results should be limited. Long-term orientation. The horizon considered should be medium-long in order to provide a wider view of performances over time. It is important to define how performances are measured because this might have a double effect. A direct effect, since the way performances are measured may influence performances themselves. For example, measuring the average delay of an activity may imply a higher number of activities with a low delay. Measuring instead the number of delays may imply a low number of delayed activities whose delay is though very high. An indirect effect. For example, measuring labor productivity may cause both overlazers and reluctant behaviors. Performances may refer to two main dimensions, effectiveness and efficiency. Effectiveness is intended as the capacity to achieve the objectives. It consists in the ratio between the output and the target. Efficiency is instead intended as the ratio between the value generated by the company and the value of the resources used for that aim. Thus, it is the ratio between the outputs and the inputs. A company can be seen from a double perspective, as a customer from its suppliers and as a supplier from its customers. Moreover, there are two types of customers a company has to consider and for which its performances have to be measured: external customers, which are the real company's customers, and internal customers, which are functions and departments which use as inputs the outputs of other upstream functions and departments of the company itself. Consistently, it is possible to distinguish between internal and external performances. Internal performances are those seen by the company and comprehend both effectiveness and efficiency ones, such as productivity and logistics costs. External performances are the ones seen by the customers, and they correspond to the four marketing levers: price, promotion, product, and customer service. Let's now consider two elements of internal performances: logistics costs and productivity. Logistics costs measure the cost of the resources, such as labor, transpiration means, plants and energy, needed to create the output of the process. The main logistics costs are transpiration costs, handling costs, cost of the inventories, cost for quality and cost for poor quality, setup costs, cost for managing orders, and the cost of the stockouts. Productivity is the ratio between the output, delivered products meeting the expectations in terms of product and service quality, and the input, production factors. It may refer to different elements such as labor productivity, energy productivity, material productivity. Switching now to the external performances, let's consider the product quality. There are four dimensions that can be considered. The design quality, which expresses if the product design responds to the customer specifications. The conformance, which measures if the products respect design requirements. The reliability, which is the ability of the product to keep its performances over time. The technical assistance, which is the ability of the system to ensure an effective technical support service for products. In this lecture, we have seen an overview about the performance measurement of a company. In next lectures, we will deepen some significant indicators that are used for the aim illustrated.